very similar mantra, but instead of Sitaram, we chant Radha Krishna or Hare Krishna. But just to give a small understanding what is the meaning, that we can easily connect, that Krishna is one of the names of God, which is considered to be most, how do you say that? It's the name which is explaining the essence of his character. Like Krishna. So Krish comes from word Karshaye, which means attraction. And Na comes from word Ananda, which means bliss. So one who is attracting and then offering bliss, he is named Krishna. That's the meaning of word Krishna. So by chanting Krishna, we are attracted and we are receiving the bliss. But in order to really work, we have to be careful about our mood and attitude. So if we chant with the attitude, I want to attract Krishna and I want to give little bliss I have, I want to offer to him, then the magic really happens. So if we have this mood, this is exactly what is going to happen to us. But if we have the mood, I want to enjoy, I want to enjoy Krishna, I want to just to get bliss, then it's really difficult. But in this way, we are becoming open to receive this real bliss. So we will chant one tune, which is from India, and it's a little bit unusual. But why not? Can I use the deaf? Can I use that?
Yes, sure.
Big one, small.
Both.
Big one is.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, this is just drum. Okay. I thought it's. Okay. This I know. You can play karatas.
What about this?
Can you play?
I don't know. I told you.
Just
only
drum.
Only one. Beat.
Play it. Oh yes. Can I get one?
You got two.
Oh, yeah. No, it's okay. One is good. Just to have some beef. Now I have to fix it somehow. Wow, this is really serious. Let's just keep it here. Please mind this piece, but it's there. lecture has a progress. It's called emotional progress. So when we connect with the tune, there is a certain motion behind. And through this emotion, we have to connect with emotion. And by this emotion, we meditate. Like, for example, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. It's a happy mood. So if we can recognize, oh, this emotion, it's the emotion of happiness, of union, then we can connect with the mantra and then we can easily meditate. As we know, in a yoga there are 8 steps, 8 stages. And the first stage is, who knows? You know, we will give you
Asana.
Yama. What is after pranayama?
Pranayama. Yama.
Pratyahara. Yeah, good. Then after pratyahara?
Dhyana.
Dhyana.
Dharana.
And final? And final is?
Samadhi.
Wow. You did 80%. Thank you.
Yeah, well, she helped me.
That's okay, she did 70. So in these stages, samadhi means complete absorption, when one can really absorb. That's really full samadhi, absorption. And before that we said dharana and dhyana. Both meanings are meditation. Like we have asana, pranayama, we know asana, these exercises which are helping our breathing process, so that we can do pranayama and do pratyahara, withdraw our senses and live life within, not without, on the outside. And then comes the stage of meditation. So dharana is a stage when you meditate and you know that. Dhyana is meditation when you meditate and you don't know that. It's like when you sleep. So if you sleep and if you know I'm sleeping, that's not really sleep, it's just beginning. But deep sleep means you don't know that you are sleeping. You think that's what is. And as soon as we meditate on that stage that we are not aware that we are meditating, then that's a very close step to samadhi or complete absorption. And one can live in samadhi or complete absorption anywhere and everywhere. But he doesn't know that. That's why he is in samadhi, because that's he's so absorbed in the divine that he's not aware of his samadhi. So that's like when someone is really drunk, he doesn't know that. As long as he knows I'm drunk, that's still the beginning stage. He's a neophyte. But as soon as he reaches the stage that he's so drunk that he doesn't know anything, that's samadhi. Don't try to drink, I'm just trying to explain the point of absorption. Don't drink some water, we just hold that. So that we can absorb and sing more. And there is a place which is very magical, very mystical place. I went there for many times, and a few times I stayed a little bit longer, for a few months. It's called Vrindavan. Have you heard about Vrindavan? So it's a place it's a village in India, and Vrindavan means forest of devotion. it's a forest of devotion. So each tree in this forest is devoted to the forest. So like if we are just like a trees, let's say this is a forest, and each one of us is a tree, and if each one of us is devoted tree, then this is a tree of devotion. And we can bring this village or this mood of Vrindavan here. So this village is special because in this village Krishna used to play with Radha, divine couple. And when you go to Vrindavan, you see everyone is so absorbed in chanting their names, and they're really living such a wonderful life. You don't see anyone unhappy, no depression, no suicide. It's amazing. And even when you see a full rickshaw, you know, this motor rickshaw driving around the village, actually you don't see the rickshaw, you just see a bunch of people. And you know, you see that group of people is moving, they know. Rickshaw must be somewhere underneath because of the sound. But they're laughing, they're joyful, and when you see their eyes, you see, they are really special. And they can live in this complete ecstasy, we can say ecstasy of bliss, because they surrender their life to the God. They are not living selfish life. So they are completely unmotivated, dedicated in serving others. So it's a wonderful place to see. When everyone is not trying to be in the center, just to be outside. And there is a story when even Krishna, when he used to play with his friends when he was in Vrindavan 5,000 years ago, he used to sit in the middle, and around Krishna, in a circle, they used to sit his friends. But everyone got the impression that he is sitting in the center. Because Krishna is so powerful that everyone was looking at Krishna, and Krishna was looking back at them. So they get the impression, oh, Krishna really loves me, he looks at me. But the starting point is that they decided, I don't want to be in the middle, but let God sit on his place, let him be in the center, and we will sit around. And what happens is completely the opposite. He puts others in the center. So there is a mantra which we will chant, very special mantra, glorifying Radha, Krishna and Vrindavan. Do you like to try?
Hare.
Thank you.
try to do with the hands. Maybe I can take, so if you can clap, then I can also play that.
Thank you.
Roshe Vrindavanda.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
this was in a beat of reggae. So we changed the beats, we changed the tunes, but we sing the mantras in whatever way. And even if you cannot produce it in a musical, very established way, still that the mantra has its power. I mean, if you just chant mantra without any music, the power is there. Because that's why we say that the mantra is transcendental, which means cannot be conditioned by any other means. You cannot condition mantra. Mantra is above everything. But one who is not above everything, or one who is conditioned, is me. We, you can say me. So everyone here is doing the same thing, but having a different experience. Because we are different, we have different mood, different approach. But everyone can say that it's something positive. It's definitely something positive. Wherever we are, whatever we think, whatever we meditate, it's strong and it's positive. And there is a difference when you do it and when you see how you feel after. And you can say, oh, something happened. Yeah, maybe harmonium is producing the side notes, but anyway, the mantra did its work. So, should we chant one more time, or we have enough time? Yeah, okay. How long we have?
Maybe until 10.
Was it 10 or can I see?
Quarter to 10.
Quarter to 10. Okay. Smaller. Oops. Thank you. Appreciate very much the way you are trying to absorb and go deep into the mantra. So I get inspiration, and it's much easier together than alone. So I would like to inspire you to do this mantra as long as possible, as much as possible, every day. Because this mantra will give you bhakti or love for God, and then you may become madman, which is good. Mad out of love. Okay. Thank you once again. Hare Krishna.